give everything we have. We give all that we have to the effort, to the preparation, to the dedication. But you got to leave something for family, man. So that's what I try to do. So I know people, you know, they want to see me come back and they say you retire too soon. And what that is they're saying we've never seen nothing like this happen before. It's different. So when you're doing something different, it's hard for people to accept. But I got to go through that. So somebody coming behind me can say, I saw him go through it, and I want to retire too, so I'm going to do it like he did. So it's a lot of emotions coming back here to the Hall of Fame. I don't know if I'm more excited to be getting inducted or with the champions I'm getting inducted with. Like, it don't make sense that my big three, I'm getting in with them. Roy Jones, Bernard Hopkins, Floyd Mayweather. Like, how did Bernard get in just 1 year before me? How are me and Floyd getting in the same year, 2021? How am I getting a year ahead of Roy? That don't make no sense.
Yeah.
Don't make no sense.
When you look at the totality of your career and your undefeated record, is there anyone out there that you wish you would have kind of matched up with in the ring?
You know, after we beat Kovalev, you know, the game plan was a cruiserweight fight and a heavyweight fight. So I know it sounds crazy to people when you 175. It's crazy until you do it, right? So, but we had always talked about that. And like, I struggle with smaller men, shorter, stockier men than I do taller. Like, I don't have a problem with guys that are bigger than me. I actually enjoy it, you know what I'm saying? Like, I grew up fighting my brother. And, you know, he was a year ahead of me. He's very tall and rangy. So I learned how to deal with a tall man most of my career. So I think not making that run, you know, like, it ain't one fighter that I'm like, okay, I want to fight him. But it's the run, you know, like, doing that cruiserweight thing. And then topping out a heavyweight, I mean, that would put me in a different stratosphere, but that wasn't in the cards.
Yeah, and if I could get one more, this is the second year that women are going to be inducted.
Man, I'm so happy, man.
When you look at that inclusivity in boxing, what do you think about that?
I love it. I'm pro female athlete, pro female boxer, and I'm one of the ones that's standing on the soapbox saying, why are they not getting the recognition? Why are they not getting better pay? You know, and I don't want to hear about the ratings. You know, I get it. I understand the business aspect of it. I've been on both sides of it, so I get it. But we can do a better job to make casual fans and hardcore fans to give them a reason to watch. And these ladies are taking the same amount of risk. These ladies, you know, and they know they got more to prove. You talk to any female boxer and you ask her, you feel like you got twice as much to prove than the fellas? They're going to say yes without even a moment's notice. So the effort is there. The risk is there, and they know that if they don't have a good showing or something happens, then the shot they had, they might not get one for a long time. So I think women being involved in the Hall is long overdue, man. I'm super excited to be inducted with the ladies I'm being inducted with. And let's go, man. I love it. I love it.
Congratulations.
Yes, sir, bro. I appreciate you, bro. Anytime, man.
When you're ready to go, slip into his seat over there, and I'll drive you out.
Appreciate you, buddy.
Ward, was this the only moment you was waiting for?
This is it.
This is it, right? The cherry on top.
This is it. All the work was about this. This is it. This is the end, man. You know what I mean? So, we made it, baby. We here. We here. All the talking, you know, good fighter, bad fighter. Beat this guy, then beat that. The debate is over, man.
Don't matter no more.
Dre, I know you mentioned it a second ago, but it sounded like you thought it was destiny that you're getting in with Bernard and Tony and Roy.
I know that sound like Sean. I know that voice.
What's up, Andre?
What's up, bro?
Congrats, man.
Thank you,
but it sounded like you thought it was almost, you know, like destiny or something, getting in with Bernard and Floyd, the guys, your muses, the guys you looked up to.
I mean, it's just, to me, it's crazy. I can't understand it. You know, like, I understand they went later. I retired. I get that part of it. I'm saying, like, let's go, right there.
You like that?
That's nice. Hold on one second. I'm sorry.
One more.
Yeah. It just, that part, like, I don't understand how I got in a year after Bernard, me and Floyd getting in at the same time, and then a year before Roy. I don't register. Like, I'm an amateur watching these guys. You know, I wrote Roy a letter when Brad Jacobs was, you know, running his company, Square Ring. I'm an amateur. Like, how I get in a year before him? You know, I grew up watching and respecting Floyd and what he brought to the game, you know, in terms of his boxing, and same thing with Bernard. So I grew up watching Layla Ali. Like, it's Ann Wolf. Like, it's just hard to register, bro.
So yeah, it almost didn't look right. All these OG legends and then Dre, who fought.
But I feel like this is a new look, though.
Mikey boy.
Younger and younger and younger. You know what I mean? Like, people, they look at a career and they see 13 years. Oh, you only did it 13 years. Nah, you got to add in that decade as an amateur, too. So that's 23 years. And then you got to look at the year I started at 9 years old. So when you do the math, you start at 9, you retire at 33. It don't seem like it's too short then, huh? So I hope, man, that, you know, I know everybody's story is different. Like, Bernard started late, so he's got to get his on the back end. Everybody's story is different. I'm not saying that my story is for everybody, but I hope that this can be the new look where we're getting in with the guys we grew up watching. And I want people saying you retired too early. I'd rather you have say that than to say I retired too late. And people looking at me like, man, he ain't doing too good. See what I mean? So, yeah. So this is, man, I don't know if I'm more excited to get the induction or to be looking to the left and the right, people that sit next to me. I don't know. Because I'm very much still a boxing fan. Like, and like, I'm a real fan. And it just takes me back to my childhood, being a kid watching Gillette Tuesday night fights. And like seeing all these, like, it's crazy. Like, I see a Layla, I see an Aaron Wolf, and I'm like, man, that's Layla Ali. I don't really get excited about celebrities and what people have. That stuff don't excite me, but people that I know walk the walk that I walk, I got respect for it, man. I got respect for it.